What made you want to do another jam?
And I don't know, must have been mental. Some people might say my life is in a rut. I'm quite happy what I got. People might say that I should strive for more, but I'm so happy I can't see that. Same things happening here today. A show of strength with your boys brigade. I'm so happy and you're so kind. You want more money, of course I don't mind. To buy nuclear textbooks for atomic crimes. And the public gets what the public wants. But I want nothing society's got. I'm going underground. You're out to hate me, I've been enough already on my plate. People might need some tension to relax me. I'm too busy dodging between the facts. You see, here's what you get. You made your bed, you better lie in it. You choose your leaders and place your trust. As their lies wash you down and their promises rust. You'll see killing machines with paper rockets and guns. And the public wants what the public gets. But I don't give what the society wants. I'm going underground.
Right, I'm here with Nicky. How are you, Nicky?
Hello.
What made you want to do another jam?
And I don't know. It must have been mental. I was actually approached in about 2019. We were going to actually do it on the old Lido grounds on the beach. But of course, COVID then came along and sort of messed things up. By the time we then decided 2021 and then 22, that wasn't available anymore. So this part of Valley Gardens came up just outside St. Peter's Church. And when they sort of told me it was going to be in a tent, I was a bit like, not sure how that's going to pan out. Couldn't quite imagine in it. And the container rooms and everything else. Anyway, when I did finally turn up, I'd kind of had so long to think about it, I decided it was a Jam and Stylecouncil exhibition, because we had so much memorabilia from the Stylecouncil as well. Just seemed crazy not to do that, really.
Yeah.
And a bit different from the other two exhibitions. So yeah, that's been quite a lot of fun to do, having that extra Stylecouncil.
And it's been so popular, hasn't it?
It's been really popular. Oh my God, it's people have really loved both seeing both the band's stuff. It's,
and then the music, you've had Nick Hayward,
the Vapors, we've had from the Jam, the Stylecouncillers, we've had Q&As with Rick Buckler. Tonight in the church we've got the screening Quadrophenia for 2 hours, and then we've got the cast, well, five of the cast from Quadrophenia coming to do a Q&A. So yeah, we've been really lucky because we were on this ground here in Valley Gardens. The church have allowed us like three nights a week for the whole month. We could do we could do gigs. So we've done a couple of Q&As and pretty much loads of different bands have played as well. I think possibly my two favourite nights, I think, was possibly the Nick Hayward. I thought
his
band,
oh
my God, his band was just incredible.
Yeah.
Just sounded like the records to me. It was unbelievable. Yeah. And he's a lovely, lovely fella as well. And from the Jam, the second night of the From the Jam gig was just electric. I thought it was great. Great to see Bruce, because him and Russ have both been ill. So.
Pretty green, I'm going to give it to the man behind the camera.
also a published author. So tell us about your books and your upcoming book.
So we've had, with me, myself, Russell and Den Davis put out a first book, which was Growing Up With The Jam, which we had at Somerset House actually, and it was a massive success. And then I brought out Growing Up With Punk about 2 years later, which I did with Barry Kane. We took it up to the Blackpool, you know, the punk rebellion.
Rebellion, yeah.
So yeah, still got quite a lot of them. That hasn't done quite as well as the Jam one.
No.
And then for this exhibition, I was actually going to have my own book ready, which is my own biography that I've been doing all the way through COVID with Barry Kane. Actually, he's sort of been my ghostwriter. But you know what? It wasn't ready, and I didn't want to rush it.
And what's it called?
It's called 8 Stanley Road.
So that's your house when you grew up?
I know, I was born there as well, so I think I've got quite a good claim to fame on 8 Stanley Road.
And is it true you chose the name Jam?
Yeah, I did. That Stanley Road, when we did it, sat round the kitchen table and I said, you know, we've had bread and marmalade and cream, what about the jam? And Paul was like, yeah, that sounds great. And then also we said we jam at school as well in the music room. So yeah, that kind of stuck. And he's given me credit for that, and I've always taken it. It's like, yeah, yeah. It was, you know, I do remember that. Yeah, it's a brilliant name. So that was, and then I started the fan club when I was 14.
Yeah.
We got kicked out of our house in Stanley Road. It's been knocked down in 76. Moved to a brand new council estate. Well, Bramall Drive was a new council estate, and hot running water and inside toilet was pretty upmarket.
Valentine Avenue, is it?
44 Balmoral Drive.
That's where you moved to?
Yeah, that's where we moved to. There was quite a few people around there that my brother went to school with, so there was lots of mates around there. Steve Carver and his brother Pete, and Tony Pilot lived across the green from us. And then I started the fan club because in 77, when the boys got signed, they were away on tour pretty much the whole of the year with my dad, and posts started turning up. So I said to Mum, I'm going to start a fan club. I'd been members of the David Cassidy and the David Essex fan club, and for £5 a week, it was a bit shit. You got a badge and a letter, that's yeah. it really.
So and I started. You did flexi discs and everything, didn't you?
I did. I mean, it was all handwritten to begin with. It was very sort of, you know, basic.
Yeah.
But then my dad used to let me bunk off school for a week, one day a week, and go up to Polydor and photocopy everything.
Really?
While he was using the phone to America or whatever. And then it kind of, you know, it grew from that really. I got a typewriter and then I got a, you know,
yeah.
didn't have a computer for years and years, but everything was kind of handwritten or typed up.
Hi, my name's Steve Tufty Carver.
And you're one of Paul's mates, old mates?
Yeah, going back 1976, I suppose. Paul moved in my back garden.
Did he?
Yeah, he actually. Yeah, in 1976, they knocked down Stanley Road in Woking.
Yeah.
And the Weller family moved into our back garden in the nearby Mayberry Estate.
So you must have a lot of stories of growing up with Paul.
My world literally changed overnight. I met Paul as a new neighbour on the Saturday,
yeah.
down the pub, introduced myself as a new neighbour, and I think within 30 seconds, 30 minutes, he asked me if I'd seen the Sex Pistols, and I was watching the Sex pistols in the newspapers following their progress. Mm-hmm. And I said, no, I've never seen him. And he said to me, well, I'm going to see him Tuesday. Why don't you come with me? So I told this story 100 times, but I think I met Paul on the Saturday. I saw the Sex Pistols with him on the Tuesday and probably witnessed the jam on the following Saturday. My life changed completely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. You know, Tuesday night down the 100 Club, the Sex Pistols, seeing an unknown, unsigned pub rock band. None of us had heard them play a note. Just went on the strength of one photograph and paid your 50p, went down, and that was it. My life just changed completely. You know, Woking was grey, dull, boring. I discovered punk rock, Soho and the Sex Pistols, followed immediately by the Jam. Within 6 months, the Jam had signed to Polydor Records. So within 6 months of me meeting Paul, he was signed to Polydor Records, and that was it. The journey started, however long it lasted, 6 years with the Jam, I suppose.
Yeah.
You know, friends, fans, roadies, T-shirt salesmen. I reckon I saw him 200 times.
Jack of all trades.
Yeah, done everything. Yeah, I ended up selling T-shirts for him.
Did you?
As you probably know through the punk rock thing, the Sex Pistols were the kingpins. They seemed to stop playing really early. They disappeared, kind of. The Clash signed. I don't remember seeing the Clash a lot. The Jam were just, they had guitars, they would travel. Paul's dad, John, would take any gig for a tenner. So literally, it seems to me, the Jam were playing every Friday, every Saturday, and every Sunday. And it was like, you know, until they got signed, well, they got signed, but they were really, really hard working. Mm. You know, I remember once John accepted a gig to replace Johnny Thunder's Heartbreakers at Hastings Pier. So, you know, we played to an audience full of Hell's Angels who expected to see Johnny Thunder's Heartbreakers, and these three blokes in mod black and white suits come on stage. Ended in disaster like it did, but it's just all part of it. Smashed up the dressing room, got away with it, went home, moved on. It fantastic times, yeah. As you all probably know, this is Nicky's third event. The first one, Somerset House, however many years ago, what was that? 10 years ago, 12 years ago. Nicky just rung me up one day and said, oh Tufty, we want to film your Woking tour. And I, what the hell for, Nicky? And she went, well, I want to put on a Jam exhibition. And I'll be honest, I kind of thought, wow, you know, who's going to pay to see some mannequins in black and white suits and a couple of guitars? But as you all know, it played off at Somerset House for weeks. I think it got extended, moved on to Liverpool.
It's been here 2 months, hasn't it?
I think, I can't remember how long it lasted at Somerset House.
And but then, here it's been at least...
Yeah, it's been a month here.
Absolutely fantastic, love it.
Been a fan of Paul Weller for long?
Yeah, well, yeah, quite a long time. But my other half's got a jacket here that she had, which is a Paul Weller tour jacket
from
the Transglobal Express tour. And we came to see the exhibition and she brought it with her and showed Nicky. And Nicky loved it, and so it's now on display.
So that's yours?
That's mine. Who are you?
Okay, Sara, so
hi.
That's yours.
It is indeed.
And you came down and bought it and gave it to Nicky
Weller? I bought it years and years ago. I've had it for years. It's been in the loft, and if you want to come around the front, it's got Paul's name on the front.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. I bought it years ago, and it was in the loft for many years. And then I came to this exhibition up in London in 2015.
Somerset House one.
Yeah. And... they had the other two of those jackets on display, and I was like, I've got one of those at home.
How did you get that?
I just acquired it from a guy a friend of mine who, but looking back, I've got some paperwork that looks as if this was given away as a prize for the fan club.
Okay.
And I think it originally went to Florida in America as first prize. And so it made its way back here, and I bought it as a little Christmas present to myself many, many moons ago.
So it's nice to see it here.
I bought it here a month ago when we came to look at the exhibition. I said to Nicky, it was in my rucksack, and I said, Nicky, I've got something in the back you might be interested in looking at. And there it is.
There it is. Brilliant.
The readers of New Musical Express said that you were the most wonderful human being. What's your own opinion on that?
Yeah, I go along with it, you know. I think they've got quite a good taste.
We got out of it, naturally love was. It's in the blood here now, she down my shirt. We won a match for their untamed wit. But some of the lads said they'll be back next week.
I think I've been here 7 days and I still haven't looked at everything. It's, you know, people just want to talk about, you know.
What do you think Paul thinks about it?
I don't know. What, you know, I'm guessing if you ask Nicky, he'd probably say, who's going to go and watch that? But I don't know. You know, of course he's proud. He must be proud of this. You've got to be proud of the back catalogue. You've got
and the
to
fact
be.
That fans, you know, 20, 30 years ago.
You know, he must be proud. Of course you would. You know, his body of work is... I've said to everyone I meet in this exhibition now, name another artist who's had three totally separate careers. He'd done the Jam, he'd done the Stylecouncil, totally different group, totally different sound, then he went on to his solo work. And my go-to question here is, can anyone think of anyone else who's done that? And always, the only person I've come near is Paul McCartney. Beatles, Wings, Paul McCartney, Jam, Stylecouncil, Paul Weller.
But he hasn't had a thing like this, has he?
I don't think the Beatles have done it. No, I part of me thinks the Rolling Stones and Bowie nicked Nicky's idea and put theirs on. But it's fantastic, you know. Like I say, I've come down here every weekend. Luckily, the sunshine.
You're from Woking now.
I'm from still from Woking. Never moved.
I'm a Guildford boy.
Yeah, there you go, Guildford. Really knows exactly where I'm from.
Cockapoo, part cheeky monkey.
Hi, I'm Derek D'Souza, photographer, music fan.
And you've done some interesting books.
I've been very lucky to do 3 books. One as a collaboration.
Yeah.
Two as a collaboration, and one of my own. But all photography related, all Jam, all jam related. I'm just going to move Lennon, sorry.
So we've got In the Crowd.
Yep, In the Crowd. In Echo Steps. It was the first In the Crowd, which is now long sold out, I'm pleased to say. And then that's the one we did release this year.
Yeah.
There was a second book in between, The Jam in Echo Steps, which was looking at, it was partly photography, but also looking at a lot of the influences that Paul Weller would have had growing up, and where he grew up, and the politics of the time. The other things he was interested in, poetry, music, films, that's those sort of things. And that was a collaboration with Simon Wells, who's very, I'm very sorry to say, has passed away. And Paul Skeller is a very talented artist.
So we just got one of the books here, have we?
I've got two of them, but there is that one, there was the other one somewhere. Oh, they're here. That one.
Okay, so is this one here?
Yeah.
So that's In Echo Steps.
Yeah.
So what's in this one?
This one is a mixture of photographs, but this is the two guys I've worked with. Simon Wells, the same, sadly passed away. He was a very talented writer. And Paul Skeller, the designer. But there's a lot of graphics, there's a lot of stuff relating to, as I say, things like, you know, what the Jam would listen to, you know, what Paul was reading, and just even where he grew up, what, you know, what influences he might have. So it's still a lot of graphics, but it's a lot of Paul's influences again, you know, what would have motivated him as a young man.
And then let's look at this book. So In the Crowd, let's have a look through it.
This one, we wanted to make it really about the photography, so it was...
Dog's running away.
Here we go.
Sorry. So this is... this is... We went and decided, because, you know, we had a chance to do it again. Can I rather reissue the book? I thought, if there's a chance to do something better and improve it, then you should take it. So we went for a bigger book, better quality print. There's 50 unseen images from the first time round.
I recognise that.
Yeah, that was at Chiswick House, which was very fortunate for me. It was the first ever photo shoot I ever did, which is amazing. Not just to photograph your favourite band, but the first ever shoot is the band, first ever photo shoot of a band who were, you know, like number one band in the country. And I was a fan, and that's how they picked me, being a fan. So, hell of a story. And I think it's why it's worked for me as well. And I think why other fans have related to me so well, because, you know,
I've seen you in an old documentary.
Yeah, I've been in a few bits and pieces with telling like my little story, but you just can't imagine it happening with anybody else, you know?
Yeah.
It just says a lot about the Jam when, or Paul, sorry mate. You know, at a time when they were so popular, he could have picked anyone. You know, any photographer in the country, and he picked some guy out of the fan club who's never done a photo shoot before.
Yeah, and you've managed to make two books.
Yeah.
And you've done a second version of that.
Yeah,
one,
well, it's 40 years since I did the photos when we started work on the book.
Yeah.
So it was, yeah.
And are you still taking pictures now? Are you still?
Yeah, I'm still. Well, there was a band, young band today, the Molotovs, who I've been working with.
So are you taking pictures of them?
Here's one you might know, alright? A disturbing echo of faraway voices, but a fire I tried. I take them home to the ones that they love and to love them forever. A grace that's in steps. I quit my own, I retrace my thoughts. Calling uninvited, totally naked, except for Sophie Rappers in this morning's papers. Mr. Joe's got a rundown. And there's a fifth of someone that's her up to now. I'm not being on her approach, but I've been down in a tree session at midnight. Fumble for change, I pull out the queen, smiling big darling. I put in the money, I pull out a plug behind me. The whispers in the shadows, full of crazy voices, as he waited. They pull a shout, and you got to me money, and I said, I've little money and I take away curry. I'm on the way, I'm to my wife. Should we like the other cutlery? I don't she's missing me. Pull the chicken because it's up, pulling up the cork. I'm down in the station at midnight. Whoa. I first felt a fist and then a kick. I could now smell their breath. Smells of pubs, wormwood scrubs, it's a lonely right with music. My life span around me, it's a cool can't jam me in solid existence. I smell of brown leather, threatened it with the weather. For my eyes, it's meant to mock a block to my sister's gonna see, but it's been getting longer. I'm down in the tea session at midnight.
Still photographing Paul. There's a few bands I see quite, I tend to photograph a few bands a lot rather than lots of bands.
Right.
But it's great, yeah, I still love doing it.
And how can people see you? Have you got your socials?
Yeah, I've got on Instagram, Derek D'Souza, on Instagram, Facebook.
Okay.
And I've got a website which is www.derekdesouzaphotography.com. Brilliant. Find me on there.
Okay. Well, look, thanks for your time.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
You never reinvent yourself, no. I just change, you know, people evolve and change. Can you describe the jam period in one sentence? Yeah, it was, they're kind of like my teenage years, you know. The style council was like me in my 20s. So to me, it's just, you know, me just evolving over time. So that's why I can't think of it as being reinventing, you know, being reinventing myself. It's kind of a natural process to me.
If you're enjoying this, smash that like button. And if you want to see hours of content that's similar to this, then check out the rest of my channel. What can you see? Well, there's interviews with old school hip hop artists. There's interviews with electronic musicians. There's even some punk.
Your shit, fuck off.
Plus there's stuff on records, vinyl, and other pop culture stuff. So subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future stuff, and do what's right. Subscribe.
Subscribe to the Skyaaz YouTube channel.
What can fans expect in the future?
I don't know really. I mean, I'm going to have a little rest after this.
I think you need it.
Because it's been quite a...
Full on.
It's quite a full on 6 weeks.
Is it a
month? It's been, well, I've been in Brighton for 6 weeks this week.
So it's, has it been a 6 week event? Because I was here on holiday.
Just over 4.5 weeks, the event. But obviously we were here building it before that. And
yeah.
It feels like I've been here for months, I've got to say. A few people have asked me, you know, where you're taking it next. And to be honest with you, it all depends if a sponsor comes along and says, yeah, you know, we'll take it to Scotland or Wales or, yeah, you know, wherever.
So
Japan,
watch this
I think
space.
Japan would be amazing, wouldn't it?
Watch this space.
Yeah, watch this space. And of course, I've going through all the archive for the Style Council and the Jam, I've literally got 12 massive boxes of Paulweller solo stuff, so which is another exhibition on
Maybe
its own.
Maybe do one of those.
I have actually spoken to Woking Council for quite a few years, actually, to see if they would do a permanent thing, but... pretty rubbish.
There's just three little bits of wood, isn't there?
There's three planks of wood which are known as pole, stick and spruce.
They got us a,
Woking Borough Council, pull your finger out.
Absolutely pull your finger out. It's just madness that there wouldn't be there wouldn't be a sort of permanent position there for them to be. I mean, that would be nice to be able to put it into a permanent place and change it up every couple of months and have events around it, but
Great seeing you, great for a chat, and fantastic exhibition.
Thank you very
and
much.
And I look forward to the new book as well.
Okay, thanks a lot.
We got time, you know. The main thing is we want to create music, right? We want to get better at music, musically, you know, instrument-wise and construction of songs, you know. There's been a lot about, like, these political bands, you know, but, I mean, I write about environments. Yeah, everything I see around me, right? And that goes out, that can appeal to a lot of people. You know?